Good morning, children. How are you all? Today, we are going to learn about the places of worship and the festivals of India. Worship is a feeling of deep respect for a god or goddess. Ceremonies are done in front of an idol. Places of public worship are known by different names. Hindus call them temples, Christians call them church, Sikhs call them Gurudwara, and Muslims call them the mosque. Priests conduct and lead prayers in all public places of worship. Hindus call them Pujaris, Christians call them fathers, and Muslims call them as the Imam. All public places of worship are well ventilated, silent, serene, and calm. In worship homes, people offer prayers, lit lamps, offer food and flowers to God, chant hymns during prayer. They also conduct puja speeches and celebrations are conducted during festive season in these places. Now, let's solve the exercises on page number 36 of the textbook. Places of worship. People pray to God at places of worship. Some of the religions followed in India are Hinduism, Islam, Christianity, Sikhism, Buddhism, Jainism, and Zoroastrianism. Complete the names of these places of worship. M O S Q U E Mosque. What is a mosque? A mosque is a place of prayer for Muslims or followers of the religion of Islam. The first mosque was built in the home of Muhammad, who was Islam's founder. Today, mosques are built in large buildings with beautiful towers and domes. The inside of a mosque always includes an open space for worship. Rugs or mats may cover the floor. Men and women worship separately in mosque. Mosque never contain statue or pictures, and music and singing are forbidden here. The Quran is the holy book of Islam. Next, C H U R C H Church. A church is a place of prayer for Christians. They go to church to give something to God, that is their worship. Christianity is known as the world's biggest religion. It is based on the teachings of Jesus Christ, who lived in the Holy Land. Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He came to earth to teach about love and fellowship. Churches are often built in the shape of a cross, with the altar facing east towards the rising sun. Christian worship involves praising God in music, speech, reading from scriptures, prayers of various sorts, a sermon, and various holy ceremonies. The Bible is the Christian holy book. The two main Christian festivals are Easter and Christmas. The cross is the main symbol of the Christians. Next, TEMPLE, temple. A temple is a building that people use for worshipping gods or for other religious purposes. The house of worship in many ancient religions were called temples. Hinduism, Buddhism, and several other religions also have temples. The architecture of temples varies from place to place. Hindus recognize these principles: God, Brahma, who creates the universe, Vishnu, who preserves the universe, and Shiva, who destroys the universe. The Bhagavad Gita is the Hindu holy book. Hinduism is the oldest religion. Major festival of Hindus are Holi and Diwali. Now, next, G U R U D W A R A, Gurudwara. Gurudwara is a place of worship for Sikhs. Sikhism is one of the youngest religions, being founded just over 500 years ago. It is the fifth longest religion in the world. The word Sikh in the Punjabi language means disciple. Sikhs are the disciples of God who follow the writings and teachings. Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhism. The sacred text of Sikhs is Guru Granth Sahib. Sikhism teaches that all human beings are equal. All Gurudwaras have the holy book, that is Guru Granth Sahib. Community kitchen, that is langar. Food is cooked in langar by the members of the community and served by the members of community to all the people at the Gurudwara, irrespective of caste, creed, religion, race, and sex. Everyone who enters a Gurudwara must cover their head and take their shoes off. Hands are washed. Everyone sits on the floor. Men and women do not sit together. Quick fact: Hinduism is one of the oldest religions in the world. More about religions. All religions teach us to live in harmony, to love and respect each other. They also teach us to do good deeds. Now, let's learn about the festivals of India. India is a democratic country. Different religions of people like Hindu, Muslims, Sikh, and Christians live together in harmony with each other. India is admired across the world for its rich culture and tradition. India is a land of festivals. These Indian festivals bind all Indians together of different caste, religion, etc. There is no discrimination while celebration. Some of the important festivals are Diwali, Eid ul Fitr, Holi, Christmas, Guru Nanak Jayanti, and many more. Let's know a little more about few famous festivals of our country. Diwali. Diwali is the festival of lights. Hindus celebrate it with joy. During this festival, people tot up their houses and shops with diyas and candles. They worship the Lord Ganesha for good welfare and prosperity, and Goddess Lakshmi for wealth and wisdom. Diwali symbolizes the victory of light over darkness, good over evil, and knowledge over ignorance. It is also called Deepavali. People decorate their homes for shopping, buying gifts for each other, perform religious rituals, etc. Diwali people wear their first clothes, decorate their houses with diyas and rangoli, offer puja to Lakshmi, light fireworks, enjoy social gatherings with lots of sweets and gifts. Eid-ul-Fitr. Eid-ul-Fitr is also called the festival of breaking the fast. It is a religious holiday celebrated by Muslims. It is celebrated to signify the end of the month of Ramadan. They celebrate by Eid prayers, charity, social gatherings, festive meals, gift giving, etc. Christmas. Christmas is a festival to celebrate the birth of Jesus. They celebrate this festival by gift giving, family and other social gatherings, symbolic decorations, feasting, etc. It is celebrated every year on 25th of December. Although it is a Christian festival, people from different communities celebrate it with great joy and happiness. A Christmas tree is an artificial pine tree which is decorated with lights, artificial stars, flowers, toys, and bells all over it. It looks beautiful when the decoration is complete. Churches are decorated with lights during Christmas, and people hang star lanterns outdoors to mark the onset of the festive season. All members of the family sit and pray together in praise of Jesus Christ. Kids are very excited about Christmas as they expect Santa Claus to visit them and bring gifts to their homes on the night of the Christmas Eve. Presents are placed under the Christmas tree, which are wrapped in gift boxes and opened on the day of Christmas. Kids sing Christmas carols like Jingle Bell. It reminds us of the importance of sharing, exchanging gifts and living in peace and harmony with our family and friends. Holi. Holi is the festival of colors. It is a day when people forgive and forget enmity or any differences with someone and meet each other with joy and happiness. Holi is the day to express love with colors. It is the time to show affection. Holi is named after Holika. Now let's solve the exercises on page number 37 of the textbook. Festivals of India. Answer the following. A. Name any two festivals of the Hindus. And the answers will be Dasehra and Holi. Name any two festivals celebrated by Christians. And the answer is Christmas, Easter. Now C. People of which religion celebrate Eid-ul-Fitr and Bakrid? And the answer is Islam. D. Which festival is known as the festival of lights? The answer is Diwali. E. On which festival do people cook pongal, a rice-based dish? And the answer is pongal. So children, I hope you enjoyed today's class. Thank you.